Hello everyone, this is Minister LT, and it's always a blessing to share another word from our Father God. Today, we're going to be talking about the number three. And in the Bible, God talks about the third time. He talks about it in the Old Testament, and he also talks about it in the New Testament. And I believe today that your Father God is talking to somebody today, the third time. And through this message today, you will hear what your Father God and trying to get you to understand and want you to listen to what it means about the third time. Amen? Amen. And before I get started, I would like to take the time out to give our Heavenly Father God the thanks, the praise, and all the glory because he deserves it all. I want to thank you again, our Heavenly Father God, for blessing me and all your children today for another beautiful and awesome day today. I want to thank you for the strength that you bless us with today. I want to thank you for our health today. I want to thank you for our vision, our hearing. I want to thank you for our voice today. I want to thank you because you are who you say you are, and you will do what you say that you will do. Because of your words, our life is better, and our path is straighter. Because of you, our Heavenly Father God, you the one died for our sins. For that reason right there, we want to say thank you. We want to say thank you because no matter what we go through in life, nobody in this whole world have our back and love us more and better than you do. For that reason right there, y'all, that's why you should thank you each and every day. Because of that reason right there, nobody will have our back and love us more than our Heavenly Father God. For that reason right there, if he blessing you and waking you up, regardless if it's your season or it's not your season, regardless you getting blessed or not blessed, for that reason right there, y'all, you should always thank and praise your Heavenly Father God. Amen? Amen. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to get into this word. And I would love for y'all to turn your Bible to John chapter 21, and we're reading from verse 15 through 17. That's John 21, and we're reading from verse 15 through 17. And if you have your Bibles open and ready to receive this word today, shout out amen. Amen. Let's begin. When they had finished eating, Jesus said to Simon Peter, which is Peter, Simon, son of John, do you truly love me more than this? Yes, Lord, he said, you know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my lambs. Again, Jesus said, Simon, son of John, do you truly love me? He answered, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said, take care of my sheep. The third time, he said to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was hurt because Jesus asked him the third time, do you love me? He said, Lord, you know all things. You know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my sheep. And I just believe right now, Jesus is telling somebody today, the third time, do you love me? Do you trust me? Do you believe in me? And I believe, I don't know who I'm talking to today, but I believe that Jesus is talking to somebody today for the third time. And he's asking you the same way that he asked Simon, which is Peter, those three things. Do you love me? Once. The second thing, do you trust me? And the third thing, do you have faith in me? And those are three things that God is asking you today. You need to listen to those three things. Because those are three things that he's asking somebody today. Somebody has been asking, somebody has been praying, and somebody has been crying. And God has heard you multiple times. And he's asking you today, right now, do you love him? Do you trust him? And do you believe in him? If that's you today, my sister, I want to say amen. If that's you today, my brother, I want to say amen. Because in that same sequence, have Jesus asked Peter those same three questions, he asked somebody the same thing those three times. And then if you go back to the Old Testament, it tell you in 1 Samuel 3:8, how God called on Samuel the third time. And I believe right now that God is doing to somebody right now. He's calling somebody the third time. And the third time is really, really a powerful number in the Bible. And it can tell you, you can go back, like I said before, you can also go back to the Old Testament and the New Testament. He talks about the third time, even the three wise men. It's in the Bible. Even if you go back even more in the New Testament, Jesus still came to Peter again by the third time. He said, when the crow crows the third time, you will deny me. So the Bible is talking about the number three a lot of time, but I believe today that our Heavenly Father God is talking to somebody today for the third time, and he's going to ask you these three things. Do you love me? Do you trust me? And do you have faith in me? And I believe that I'm talking to somebody directly today. And he's put in my heart for me to minister this word to somebody today. I know it can be me too. So I'm not going to say that I'm going to count myself out, because I go through the same thing that some of y'all go through. And most of the time when I'm ministering this word, somebody is talking about me. But I'm going to do my job to also to minister the word, because I know if he's talking to me, he also is talking to somebody out there too as well. I believe and declare that right now in the mighty name of Jesus. But I just want y'all to just take time out through the whole day or whatever you're doing right now. Your Heavenly Father God wants you to ask those three things. Do you love me? Do you trust me? And do you believe in me? And bless you today. I want y'all to really just meditate on those three things. Because whatever God, your Heavenly Father God, is coming to us today, just like he did Peter. Trust, love, and then we have faith in him. We got to believe in him. We got to believe that everything that we ask for, that we know is going to happen for us. We got to trust that we know is going to happen to us. And we got to love him, because he loves us. He didn't take us this far in life just to leave us. He didn't take us this far in life just to leave us behind. That's why he wants to ask all this thing. Do we love him? Do we trust in him? And do we believe in him? If you know that, I mean, really, really know that in your heart, that our Heavenly Father God will take us to the next level, we have to know those three things. Those three things got to stick in your head. It got to stick in your mind. Put a sticky note on your refrigerator. Put a sticky note on your bathroom wall or through your door or in your car. And at least ask those three things. Love, trust, and believe. Those are three things that God is going to ask us today, just like he asked Peter. Those are three things got to stick with us for the remainder of time to God open that next chapter in our life, y'all. Are you following me? Am I making sense to somebody today? Because I know I am. And I believe in the club. We can just do those three things, y'all. God's going to do the rest. But we got to trust him, y'all. We got to believe him. And the main thing, we got to love him. Because he loves us. He loves us so much. He will know about us this far in our life. Y'all, remember that. He will never about us this far in our life. Is he going to come through, or he going to make a way for us? He would never done that. He loves us too much for him to do that to us. So that's one thing I know.
With USA Bank.
That I know that he's not going to do that. But we got to learn how to trust him. We got to learn how to believe in him. And we got to learn how to have faith in him, that he's going to do it, that he's going to make a way, just like Simon. Just like how he did right there. We got to do that. Once we do that, everything will come the way that God want to do it. Amen. And before I close my service today, remember those three things. We got to love him. We got to trust him. And we got to believe him. If you can remember those three things, I think everything will be okay, y'all. And I just wanted to share this word with y'all today, and how the word of God always talk about the three things. You can also go to 1 Samuel 3:8. They tell you the same thing too as well. And if you receive this word today, I want you to shout out amen. And I never like to leave my short broadcast without leaving with a prayer. Can you please pray with me? Lord Jesus, I ask of you to come into my life, to take over, to guide me, direct me, use me, so I can build a relationship with you. And I believe right now in the mighty name of Jesus, by your praying a simple little prayer, that God is already working everything out of your life right now. And if you ever want to get in contact with me, my YouTube channel is withers.lt. Or leave me a comment on Instagram at withers.lt. Remember, keep God first place in life. He loves us and he trusts us. In Jesus' name.